Greetings, welcome. Greetings and welcome. Bear with me. Giving y'all some time. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Happy Saturday. I'm back. Earlier I shared a little tip for detoxing and all of that. And so now I want to come on. I forgot to change the title. I do apologize. Actually, I think this is what I want to do. I think, hold on, bear with me if there's anybody coming in. I forgot to change the title of the live, so I do apologize for that. Anyway, hope you're having a wonderful Saturday, if it is Saturday that you're actually logging on and seeing this. So you're looking at, it says in 2022, I should follow my dreams. Now, actually, I was just inspired to hop on to talk a little bit about, I saw a wonderful reader whom, you know, I resonate with some of her readings. Now, we're not exactly the same. You know, we don't necessarily line up with everything with one another, but I have respect for readers, okay? I have respect for people that I can sense they're on the path, even if they're unique, you know, or different than myself. But I can still sense sincerity, authenticity, and truth, okay? Even if I can't quite, you know, agree with every single thing. But it's one of the beautiful readers that I do listen to and follow. And I actually believe that, man, they may have a little bit more experience than me when it comes to, like, some of the darker stuff. Like, they've really been dealing with, you know, the fact that on the twin flame journey, you deal with a lot of the distorted spiritualist energies. Okay, so they have a little bit more background in that than myself. But anyway, I digress. So I didn't get to look into the reading. I just saw something she said and I was like, well, yeah. So I didn't even go deep into what she was saying. I think it was like on a little post. And so I'm like, this is resonating with me. It's kind of what I've been saying for over a year, maybe plus, maybe 2 years. In terms of, she was talking about the twin flame journey. I was like, oh girl, honey child, honey child, honey child. And she made a statement. She said, you know what? She said, one of the clues, and I'm like, hello, is like when individuals who get obsessed with this journey, okay, and they're trying to clench on to counterparts, she said like that was a clue that they're karmic. She was like, the fact that they're more obsessed with the twin flame journey than they are their own healing, then it's evident they're karmic. I was like, boom, mic drop. That's all you need to say. I was like, that's all she needed to say, because this thing is about healing. People don't really get that the essential main theme of this type of journey ain't got nothing to do with this shit that we focus so much on in the 3D. So people get all glamorized with that concept, and I'm your soulmate and I'm your twin flame, and you know, but now none of them doing no kind of healing. And so she proved the point that I've been saying for a long time. That's the number one assignment. Ain't no other assignment gonna trump that for a twin flame. Okay. They trigger one another, but if they're truly twins, something is gonna happen. Okay. There's gonna be one that truly awakens, usually before the other, and they're gonna be the ones that's hell bent on, okay, look, I'm going on this journey to heal. I ain't gonna time for no crazy shit. You know what I'm saying? Because that's why that was set up in the contract, that all of this lower vibratory shit was to serve to point us to our healing, but not to keep us in the density, not to keep us in karmic cycles and repeating the same shit. If that's the case, now I do want to add a disclaimer, twins can be in karmic cycles, but the only reason why this happens is because one or both of the counterparts aren't following the source and their guides to heal. So in other words, instead of healing and being willing to let go of a counterpart, they keep going back. They keep staying in it when they know they still up to fuck shit, when they know they still dealing with karmic horrors, when they know they still toxic as fuck. Okay, so that's what's called a karmic cycle within a twin flame journey. Somebody has to stand the test and go, okay, no. No matter what, because that's the number one assignment. Break any toxic karmic cycle, heal, go within, deal with the trauma of your bloodline, the trauma of the life that you've lived in the carnation. Deal with that. Awaken. That's the number one priority. Awaken. Get the hell out the matrix. Okay. Anything out, you know, shy of that, then people is just doing some, you know what I'm saying, this 3D shit. Oh, I'm your twin. No, you ain't, motherfucker. No, the fuck. Okay. It's like, it is not, I'm sorry. It's funny to me because it's not about rules and regulations. And like, people get stuck on all this 3D shit. It's like, no. Primary, heal. Be willing to walk away from counterpart. This has to happen. This is the only way to break the karmic cycle, okay? Even if there's never a union in 3D. But energetically speaking, it breaks the karmic cycle, okay? And so I wanted to say, like, guys, the goal is for us to heal and we should be following our dreams. This is why you see it. In 2022, I should heal. Follow my dreams. It's not about, you know, okay, I got to get to know now your dreams. Following your heart and your dreams, then essentially you're going to co-create and manifest that. It's going to happen for you. It ain't this twin flame journey. Excuse me, this twin flame journey. In respect to like this 3D shit, I should say. It was about awakening and healing the whole time. But when twins refuse their healing and they have a lot of karmic family and lovers, which are past life karmics, by the way, usually, I wanted to talk about that a little bit. The reason why those connections be feeling just as intense is because they're past life as well. They be past life lunatics. Yes, yes. Yes. Yep. And it all served, though. It was supposed to be designed as lessons. Awaken to this. Don't fall prey to this. Don't fall prey to that. Learn, you know, so these are all lessons for divines. That they, you know, set up to learn each time, lifetime after lifetime, if they didn't learn it the previous one, blah, 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 blah. So, because the karmics are going to come in on the weaknesses and on whatever drama and trauma happened in previous lifetimes. That's why on my particular journey, there are several, okay? There's several. I say this all the time. They know who I am. They know who I am. And I'm not talking about just in this 3D. They know who the hell I am. This is why they were so insistent on being in DM1's ear the entire time. Whether they wanted to admit that or not, some of them, you know, have gotten full knowledge, but others is just like, in the subconscious. Okay. So subconscious and that DNA and that blueprint, they know who the hell I am. That's why some of them try to copy me. Some of them try to look like me, walk like me, talk like me, sound like me, do what I do. Okay. This is why they did the mirror shit to try to swap and switch to get my energy signature to make DM1 swap it, right? When DM1 is asleep, he don't have any sense. He can't see any clearer than they can. Okay? So this is why. But if you're divine, the test is going to be, are you willing to let go? Are you willing to walk away? Are you willing to let go? Are you willing to walk away in the name of why you came in the first place? In the name of why are you here? Why did you incarnate here? Why did you agree to the contract? Why? Essentially, to heal, to balance the masculine, feminine energy within oneself, to heal a bloodline, to awaken, to ascend. That's the primary reason. And if the counterpart is refusing their journey, they're only going to be a blockage. Okay? Which is not what you came here to do. So, for an example, when counterparts, whether it's a masculine or feminine, when they stay asleep, unfortunately, it's usually masculine, but I get why. Okay? When they stay asleep and they still have a lot of karmic energies, which is past life lunatics, people that they had past life, you know, lessons that they were supposed to learn in another lifetime, but they didn't. It followed them in this lifetime. They were supposed to be learning, cut the hoe off, like we was trying to tell you in the last life. Okay. We was trying to teach you last lifetime, stop selling out for money, motherfucker. You know, like whatever it is. So what happens, y'all, is I have to make it funny. That's why y'all hear me talk like that. But anyway, what happened is if they're dealing with the type of karmics that do the rituals and the spell works and the really dizzy, weird ones, okay? Then, unfortunately, they don't see right. Their vision is obscured. They actually think these karmics be divine until they wake up and heal themselves and start really dealing with shit. They actually be thinking these motherfuckers are divine, even in distortion. So they will, under these spell works, the sex magic or whatever the fuck, you know, try to collaborate with these karmics to connect to the divine feminine. And I'm gonna tell you guys why. Okay, some of you may say, especially if you resonate as a divine feminine, you may go, what is the point of that? Shouldn't they be happy? Hell, they bitch and moan shit. They go through all these changes. They bitch and moan, okay, to get the motherfucker. They bitch and moan. They sit and spin. You know what I'm saying? They go through all these changes to get the motherfucker. Okay. So once they got the motherfucker, what's the problem? What is the obsession with divine feminine? Why is divine feminine brought into an equation on any level and for any reason? If they have managed to get deep the divine masculine and the physical, what's the point? Isn't that what this has been about? They're obsessed. They want to be divine feminine so bad. They want this twin flame union energy so bad and wooty woo. So why they ain't happy then? why they stalking divine feminine then? Why they on her getting down and shit and trying to do her mannerisms and shit and trying to fucking shit. This is nuts. But I'm going to tell you why. It was shocking to me, but this is the reality, okay? First and foremost, they're asleep. Sleep and full of pain, drama, trauma, all kinds of, you know, sin issues. And when I say sin, I'm not talking about in the traditional sense. I mean addictions and attachments and habits, low vibratory energy, attached, fucked up, chakras fucked up, just fucked up. Right? And fancy outfits. Okay? So, they're distorted. But subconsciously, they know something is different about divine energy. Some of them, the black witches, distorted spiritualist energies that are into it, they know, they just know the truth. They know who divine feminine is, and they know what that energy is all about. So they become obsessed. And that's why they'll agree when they're dealing with divine masculine, okay, in his sleep state or his toxicity, they'll appeal to his lust. And so they come off as these really cool and understanding broads, right? Wow, you know, she really accepts me as I am. She, you know, she says that she don't care if I go have sex with so-and-so or if I go connect with divine feminine for whatever, you know what I'm saying? Whoop-de-whoop. And in their disillusionment, they're mistaking this as loyalty, commitment, and love. But that's not it. The reason why they allow this is because first and foremost, they're empty and void. The only way they know how to manifest is through spell work and other people's energy. Their obsession with the twin flame journey and divine masculine and divine feminine. So if they allow divine masculine to connect with divine feminine, he gets to feed. In this type of a union, he gets to feed. He gets the creativity, all of that beautiful energy that is designed within this twin flame journey. And how does this benefit the karmic? Because if he's still in his distortion, he's absorbing divine feminine's energy, and then he run his dizzy ass, you know what I'm saying, over there to try to take care of their low budget asses. Okay, with the energy in which he has absorbed from being involved or connected to divine feminine. Okay, so they know that they benefit. It keeps him happy. He gets creative. See, some of them put the pieces together. If he connects to divine feminine, all of a sudden, he's energized. All of a sudden, he's happy. All of a sudden, he's got a burst of good luck that seems to dissipate as soon as divine feminine get pissed off. Soon as divine feminine get pissed off and find out what the fuck's going on, it's like, oh, shit. Luck over, bitches. Luck over, bitches. Okay? So... this is why they allow that. So if you're divine feminine and you know a masculine is distorted and you know he's dealing with karmic nuts and he, you know, he's if you know it, cut him off. Don't feed. As soon as you pick it up in a conversation, cut him off. Nope. You ain't finna use my energy to manifest with these dizzy nuts. How about y'all do a spell to create? What's going? What's wrong? What's the problem? Shit. Oh, shit. What's the problem? And essentially, they're trying to use divine feminines, you know, first and foremost, to try to tie themselves to the legacy. You can't. It's not going to happen. You can squeeze out a baby. You can get married. Ain't going to happen. Okay? Don't work like that. So they figure by tying, allowing masculine to somehow tie with divine feminine is going to get him to get the legacy. He gets shit. Understand. If he is still fucking with karmic energies and violating his own soul's journey, he gets shit. Everything that they get turns into like chaos, a curse. It just doesn't work like that. You got to like overwork to get it. It's not the real legacy. It's not the gift. It's not the blessing. So it's an attempt to tie with the legacy because the legacy lies with the surrendered soul. And when they know that divine feminine is on the path, so then they'll allow like, okay, so hopefully divine feminine could absorb some of the karma. Whoa, that energy harvesting shit. I'm telling y'all, don't do it. I don't care, man. If they fucked up, let they asses. That's their journey. But don't feed. No. Okay. One day folks will wake up, hopefully on this, you know, this lifetime, you know, for themselves and shit. Like finally catch a clue. Light bulbs. Right? But this thing is about awakening. Enjoying your life and journey, but awakening, breaking patterns, healing, ascending out of that density. Not just a sage bundle and shit. You can't get... Damn, man. It ain't like that. So if you're resonating as somebody that, you know, you haven't embraced your path, just know, if you're asking yourself, you know, going round for round, especially if you're newer, everybody's talking about twin flames, everybody's talking about this, everybody claim this. Sure. Sounds exciting, right? Divine souls, those are old souls, they're unique, right? It's an energy issue. It's an energy thing. It ain't an outfit. I'm telling you right now, it's not an outfit. God damn it. It ain't an outfit. You can study all the fuck you want. You can Google, bitch. It ain't like that. You don't get to just decide in this life. That's not how it goes. Now, everybody can manifest, okay, a soulmate, because we are all experiencing stuff like that. But you can't just decide, oh, I saw that on YouTube. Well, but if that ain't your soul, though, what if your soul ain't, that ain't, that's not, man, it don't mean it's better or less. It just means that's not your soul's get down this time. And this is why Source be getting pissed and ancestors be going off and all, you know, giving hell to karmics, because they be like, we told they whole ass. We said, look now, we tried to be nice. This ain't for you. But they insist. So we're just going to let them have fun with that until they wear their whole ass out in the end. Okay? Sorry, y'all. Please, if you're divine beings, no matter if you're newer on the path or you're more seasoned, continue to focus on your ascension and healing. And if you have people like, you know, the lunatics coming out the woodworks trying to come in talking about they yo this and they yo that, watch their life, man. See, I had to learn how to stop. Just stop over focusing on the external or what's coming out the person's mouth per se. I had to really learn how to just stop and look at their life. I'm not talking about how we've all gone through seasons and changes and yada yada. I'm talking about, no, if you your ass is talking about whoa, you this and that, why your whole ass over here, so you need to not be saying that. Because that is not computing. It's not computing. You're trying to set people up. You're poisoning people. Something's, that's not computing. You're putting spells on divine beings that hasn't had a chance to awaken and heal. Then you, no. No. And also, I want to say that the counterparts that wake up and start doing their journey and healing, whether it's the masculine or the feminine, whichever one gets there, they hold the power, they hold the key, and they are more powerful than the other one. Yep, at that time, they hold the power. Because if the other individual is still in a low vibration, they're still karmic, they're still asleep as fuck, the only thing they can do is essentially more fuck shit that's gonna be more hell for them, or eventually just decide to surrender to their higher self to start their process. But they don't have power in the dynamic of the twin flame journey or over the counterpart because they're not surrendered. So it's very interesting to me. So it serves us to just like, okay, disconnect yourself. If you know, I don't care what you believe about it, what your title is. If you know it's off, it's off. If they're still trying to be 2-3D, because some of them just stay stuck and so 3D, so their mind is narrow. And so they're trying to, you know, like project their crazy onto you, essentially. Oh, you watch too much TV. Oh, no, that's, you know, motherfucker, you speak for yourself with your own crazy. Because see, it's the unseen that's a little bit more real than the seen anyway. This shit is an illusion. So Sally Sue Homemaker with the apron and shit is a fucking illusion. Now that's why, you know what I'm saying, you'll ask. So if they coming at you with that, okay, say bye-bye, baby, bye-bye. Don't sit there trying to explain. This is something, the matrix has to be experienced. Getting unplugged has to be experienced. It cannot be told. You have to journey this. Otherwise, it's a losing battle. So this is not something that we're meant to try to convince. We're here to heal, grow, ascend, transform, truly break this toxicity that these ancestors and, you know, bloodlines, those who came before us, they didn't finish doing, whatever the case. So we ain't like our damn daddies and mamas and fucking, you know what I'm saying? Whoa. And I'm not talking about just on external, because some of you or some folks out there, they get stuck on, oh yeah, they never had a job. I had a job. They never got an education. I got an education. They never, okay, but are you still fucked up though? How about that? Let's talk about that. You fucked up? You still fucked up? You're still a fucked up ass person? Then you have not broken the things that the ancestors have in mind. You're still doing toxicity within the bloodline. That's some of the stuff we come here for. Was there abuse? Was there molestation? Was there incest? Was there thievery? Was there abandonment? Was there rejection? What was in the blood? Were you dark witches? Religious nuts, but sacrificing your own kids. What was it? What's in the blood? Talking about you saying a prayer for them, but don't give a fuck. That's a curse. Disconnected. Deal with it. That's what divine beings came here to deal with. Okay? Not this putting on a show. I go to church every Sunday. I'm the deacon. I'm the this. Or I own my own Reiki center. And that none of this stuff means shit in and of itself. Who are you? See, we have to ask these questions to ourselves. Who are you? Outside of the you know, tap dance and performing monkey for motherfuckers. Who are you? Your character. Your heart. Not the shit we do for photo ops. Who are you? That's what this journey, this twin flame journey is about. And not everybody, people do forfeit it. And, you know, because it requires a brave soul to be able to truly walk out these types of contracts. Some end up getting penalized severely, not because they didn't uphold the contract. I'm being guided here soon. I'll be doing a reading on the proper way to close a twin flame contract and why some of the counterparts end up getting some severe bad karma. Because according to the world of energy, universal laws, there's a way to do everything. Just like in the 3D. There's an easier way to close out some type of a legality contract. There's usually some type of a clause in there that says, you know, blah, blah, blah. And then there's a more severe way that may cost you more for causing unjust undue damage. So likewise with the twin flame journey, some of these individuals get severe whoop ass because the nature in which they broke the contract, not because they broke the contract. It's more about, okay, all that was occurred in the fact because somebody just didn't want to do it. When guys was probably trying to help folks, like, look, if you don't want to incur some whoop ass in this life, and if you have another, the next, we highly recommend, we're recommending that you don't try to hurt your counterpart. We're recommending that you have some damn integrity and some balls. Okay. This will minimize the severity on you. You're going to suffer from your own choice dilly-dallying with karmics anyway. But it will minimize getting with karmics to do something to a divine being is going to cause you severe whoop-ass. We highly recommend. We recommend that, look, y'all can go wherever you want to go and be where you're, wherever you want to be, but we recommend you don't try to fuck with the counterpart. That's what's going to cause you and the karmics. As long as you try. So, and the reason some may say, well, why do they do this? Because they're karmics and they're asleep. And just like bugs prefer to operate when the lights are off because they can't be as easily detected and seen as it is with these individuals. Those that are awakening and healing is a light, which means their illusions will have less and less effect on people. And that is a problem. Okay, so this is why they do that, whether they're fully consciously aware of it or not, but this is why they'll target the ones that are actually awakening and ascending. Gosh, we cannot have people knowing the truth. Oh God, we cannot have people empowered and free. Oh Lord, because then they ain't going to be under my power and control. I'm not going to be on no pedals. Oh shit. Yeah. Then my illusion, my fake persona, is not going to have the same effect. Focus on the path. This is how you can mark a true divine over a karmic any day. Healing. They're usually purpose driven. If you start paying close attention to those, and I'm not talking about copying somebody, sitting on some your duff, sitting there and shit. That's an energy too. Pay attention. But just mark, watch, and sense. Not just the external, just sense it. Feel into it. Not people that you like, yesterday they was this, and today, because they saw Divine Feminine do this, now they whole ass then went and did some shit, just so happened. Bloom from joy versus bloom from... I'm just saying, it's the motivation. It's the intention. Are they willing to let you go? Listen to me. If not, if they're threatening you You know, and I'm not talking about that early stage of shit like that. I'm talking about if this has been an ongoing thing between you and a person for extended period of time, and they're trying to say they're a divine counterpart, your eyebrows should be raising up. Okay. All right. So in 2022, I should follow my dreams. Yes, we should be following our dreams, but check. Hold on. Hold the telephone. Man. Wait, where did it go? Hold on. Bummer. Hold on. Hold on, guys. Wait. I don't even know which one I got on here. I just touched out on an accident. Hold on. Because I want another one. I want to get another one. I wonder how come it's not showing me. Let me see. Well. Okay, I took it off. I'm just going to click on them. Fuck it. Nope. Y'all like this lady. I want to click it again to give y'all another message. Nope. Wait. Okay. Yeah, that's weird. Let me go here. No. All right, so then maybe it's not meant, because I actually yay. Thank you, spirit guys. Yay. That's I whoa. In 2022. I should start that side hustle. What I really feel is with that is going for your dreams. You know what I'm saying? Passive income, right? In other words, you know, doing things or creating things that makes money for you in a way without having to work so hard. So having like multiple streams of income, but more like passive income as well to come in for you. Yeah, done right there. Oh, show enough. See, this has been my thing. 2022 was that's been my mantra. That's been my theme. Like, I'm cutting off everything in my life and everybody that pose a threat to true self-love in my life. Meaning, if people are disrespectful and they're not changing their behavior, or they feel like they don't have to, or if something's not serving in a high vibrational way, and you know, liars and thieves and whores, oh my, people who feel like they can just run in and out, you know, when somebody whoop their ass out there in the world and they want to come to the kind ones, you know what I'm saying? That kind of shit. Cutting it off, that's not loving to me. So in 2022, I should love myself absolutely. Okay, this is a theme. So yeah, get that business going. Whoa. Yeah. I won't say make more friends. I'll say higher vibrational, a new selective friend group that's more in resonance with who you're aiming to become, your true essence, where you're going versus where you've always been. If where you've always been is toxic, chances are it's a bunch of toxic fucks that you need to shake. Okay, let's see here. Yes, take that risk. Absolutely. Divinely guided risk, of course. No more risk on those and things that have proven to make you sit right down and hold your head. But taking the risk that the soul has been calling us to, right? Divinely guided risk. Okay. Earlier today, I did a little tip with you guys about like detoxing the body, a product that you can use to become healthier. Absolutely. Now is the time. More water, more water, more water. That's the thing. Follow your dreams. I'm not going to say sleep more. I'm going to say better rest. You know, more consistent rest, REM sleep, right? Getting a more satisfying sleep life, okay? Because more is not always better. Yeah, we already talked about that. I don't want that one. Yeah, I was waiting for it. Done. Pull a bloomy. A swap and switch a roux and shit. Change your whole get down. Like, y'all ain't gonna even know who I am, motherfuckers. Whole, never me. But it starts from the inside out. The glow up is from the inside out. And you have a right to co-create yourself and your avatar as you wish. But I do want to add that, well, let it be something from the inside. Glow up from the inside. This is going to heighten the glow up on the outside, right? Yeah. All right. Enough of that. Enough. So, anyway, I hope these little discussions help those of you that resonate with what I do. I know I haven't put the other one on YouTube yet. I plan to put these two, the one I did earlier, and this one up for sure, okay? If I have time, I'm trying to create a different little setup. And what I have at my disposal, if I have time, it may be pretty late. It may be late tonight. I will come on to do a past life reading, okay? Those of you who are like wanting an Akashic past life reading, wanting to know like who were you and like what was the point, you know, in terms of whatever happened then and why you incarnated now. If I have time, I'll be coming on to do a past life reading, finding out who were you in a past life, right? What happened and how does it connect to this life? How does it connect? And what were you, what did you sign up to learn in this life that came from the previous lifetime? Okay. All right. So that's if I have time, because that's a very involved reading. So we'll see what happens. Okay. All right, you guys, sleep more or sleep better, right? Sleep more or sleep better. Let me give y'all a closing live. For those of y'all who's looking for a live message, let's see. Bring something to heart and mind about love. What y'all want 2022 for this year old? All right. Well, then get out there. Co-create with the universe. I don't like the word find. I'm going to say attract, manifest, co-create. In action, divinely guided actions, all right, to what you have been manifesting, because you sure enough can if that's what you want to do. All right, I'll talk to you guys later.